everybody, Seth Rudetsky, continuing my Evita deconstruction. Now, by the way, this is sort of an honor of the concert I did with Patti LuPone on Broadway for Broadway Cares Equity Fight Stage, raised more than $200,000. She still got it, and I made her belt her bache off. Okay, we're going to start with Buenos Aires. So if you don't know, Evita first began as a concept album, meaning that it wasn't even staged. It's Angela Weber and Tim Rice with this great score, and they're like, let's just get the London Philharmonic and record it, as we all do. Anyway, so they get this full orchestra to record it, but the orchestrations have really changed since it got to Broadway. Well, once it got to Broadway, it kind of went through the White Album, as we call it, through the London production, and then to Broadway. So it didn't have that signature, you know, what's new, that amazing piano part. Instead, it was just like a guitarist riffing. It was like ding, 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 ding. Here, listen to it. It's Julie Covington. Listen to the sort of ding, 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 ding. Here we go.
What's new, Buenos Aires?
Just sort of.
I'm you. I wanna say I'm just a little stuck on you. You'll be on
okay,
me
by
too.
By the way, you know she's British, so I'm obsessed with her liquid you. On the word new. Here we go. Here, have a listen. Liquid you.
What's new, Buenos Aires?
Okay, so now when Patti does it, when Patti took over. So we add that signature. Ba, 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 ba. Okay, then I love that Patti goes, there's always a riff. What's new? Buenos Aires, Buenos Aires. So there's always a sort of a mordant, as we say in the business. Buenos Aires. Then I love that instead of going, I'm new, she goes, I'm new. I love the back phrasing. Back phrasing means you take something like a little bit out of the rhythm as long as you keep it within the beat. So she's back phrasing that. Then I never really heard the expression star quality. I don't know if it's because it's a British expression or because I thought it was a British expression because I was only 13 when I heard the album and I was like, this doesn't exist in America. Regardless, she talks about star quality. But the crazy part is A, it's actually on an E. So letter A, she has to end on an E. And by the way, it's a crazy little note. It's not even the only E in the song. It's just every 20 measures, I have to hit a low E. Why does she have to hit a low E? So that's the first thing that's crazy. Second thing that's crazy, it doesn't really relate to Patti, but relates to my friend Whitney Mallon's mom. So normally it goes, just a little touch of star quality. My friend Whitney Mallon's mom thought it was, just a little torture starts with a T. First of all, why did you think it was a revival? No, what's the next thing? A sequel to the song Trouble from Music Man with a capital P and that rhymes with, okay, just a little torture starts with a T. Not the point. Okay, so here we go. So you have to listen for the bunk, bunk. Oh, also, the last thing I want to say. So Angela Weber, I feel, is always getting dished for being like kind of a simple composer. I don't even know why he gets dished, but the point is his music is so complex. Two things I want to say. There's constantly atonal, like just weird stuff, yet it doesn't sound atonal. You're like, that totally makes sense. You'll hear it in the song. B, he always has such complex meters, meaning like, you know, time signatures. And what I love about complex meters, it's amazing when it doesn't sound like, oh, wait, there's a beat missing. Instead, you're like, it totally makes sense to me, and yet the rhythm, and yet the meter keeps changing. Like, it still has a sassafras. Like, for instance, what's new? We're in four. Buenos Aires. I'm new. I want to say one, two, three, four, one, two. It literally has a 2-4 measure in the middle, and yet it completely works. All right, remember all these things. Here we go.
What's new? Buenos Aires.
Down part. Back phrase.
I'm new. I want to say I'm just a little stuck on you. You'll be
one,
on
two.
Me, too.
Mordant?
Buenos Aires! Stand back! You wanna know what you're gonna get
Mordant?
In me? Just a little touch of star quality.
Crazy low E. Oh, did I even say about that? Sorry. I just wanna say, throughout the song, I feel there's a struggle between major and minor. Just a little. So it's minor, major, Picardy third, minor. Major. It reminds me of also, do you know in the middle of A Boy Like That? When she goes, oh no, it's a no. Major, minor. Anyway, I feel there's a struggle throughout the song with that. Okay, then speaking of major, minor, the whole bridge. It's like minor, major, minor, major. Okay, so that's happening. Also, what I love is that you really hear the piano in the bridge. Here's the thing. You hear this all da-da-da-da-da-da. The reason I love it is that you rarely hear pianos when there's a full orchestra musical. Okay, by the way, you hear a lot of piano when there's a cheapskate Broadway musical, when it's like piano, a string quartet. Don't get me started on that new trend. What I'm saying is in the old days when we had full orchestras, which what a Broadway musical should have, you rarely heard piano. So I love that throughout this, in the middle, you kind of hear the piano sticking out. Okay, here we go. Is that it? Minor, major? Here we go.
Just a little touch of star quality.
Minor.
Fill me up with your heat, with your noise, with your dirt, with your energy. Let me dance to your feet, make it loud, let it hype, run it through me.
Piano.
Don't hold back, you are certain to impress. Tell the driver this is where I'm staying.
Okay, love that. Then I like the trumpets going bum bum, da da bum bum. It just makes it extra sassy. The trumpet orchestration. I also love the just when you hear the bridge again. I just love the repeated 16th notes of the violin. Ticka 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 dum bum. Love that. Then I'm also impressed by Tim Rice's rhymes. He makes you wait till the next stanza to hear the rhyme. You know, first goes don't hold back. You're starting to impress. Tell the driver this is where I'm staying. Second line is, second time, like 16 measures later, don't hold back, you are certain to impress, tell the singer this is where I'm playing. So it's impress, excess, staying, playing. I think it's a brava that you have to wait all these measures and your mind still retains that there's a rhyme there. Here we go.
Tell the driver this is where I'm staying.
Violins.
Take me in, it's your blood, give me speed, give me life, let me humming. Shoot me up with your blood, warm me up with your knife, watch me coming. All I want
rhyme
is a whole lot of excess. Tell the singer this is where I'm playing.
Okay, stand back. Now there's even more trumpets. Now instead of bump bump, bonum, now it goes bump bump, bonum bonum. So the trumpet's now playing the entire phrase. Yet again, da 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 da. She has to hit another low E. Who has the energy for that? And by the way, a part of me thinks it was floor mics. You know what, whether it's floor mics or not, it's a low E. Is that all I have to say about that? Yeah, here we go.
Tell the singer this is where
Trump
I'm playing.
Ready?
Stand back where the fight is. Because you want to know what you're going to get.
Low E.
Just a little touch of star quality.
Then, by the way, the current low E on Broadway is in this show. Can I play it? Yeah, here we go.
That good.
But at least it's the end of the song and it happens a time. Patty has to sing the low E throughout the entire song. Okay, then on top of that, where am I? Okay, then on top of that, she's on this low, crazy E. Surely she gets to kind of gradually move her way up. No, not gradually at all. She goes from a low E to a high C. Low E, up an octave, then more than an octave and a half. That's crazy. As you know, when Patti LuPone first heard the score, she was like, Andrew Lloyd Webber hates women. Maybe he does, but he loves me. All that belting, I love it. Okay, here we go. That's how high she has to go. Now, by the way, if you're thinking, well, that C can't be so high. Really? The end of Everything's Coming Up Roses, the climax of Act One, Ethel Merman, the premier belter, like, I'm finally gonna give you my big note. It's the exact same note. The amazing big note Ethel Merman finally gives at the end of Act One is the same note that Patty begins on for this next phrase. Here we go, listen.
Everything's coming up roses for me.
The biggest note in the world. I hit the highest note in the world. Really? It's the beginning note of Patty's phrase, and then she has to go higher. She has to say, just the beginning. Why would it? Okay, here we go. Listen to this craziness. Merman.
Yeah!
Highest note in the world. And then Patty just. Come on, that's amazing singing. Okay, what do I have to say about this? Okay, I did Merman, Patty. Oh, okay. So yet again, Tim Rice does that thing where he begins a rhyme and then, like, you know, 18 measures later, whatever, he does the next rhyme. So he goes, and if ever I go too far, it's because of the things you are. So first of all, there's a kind of internal rhyme. Far, it's because of the things you are. Beautiful town, I love you. And then, and if I need a moment's rest, that was your new rhyme scheme. Give your lover the very best. Real eider down, the down rhymes with town. Okay, but to remember, the end of the phrase is and silence. So sort of like, okay, he rhymed. He rhymed far, are, and then town, and then he rhymes rest, best, and then down. So the end of that phrase is I love you. It's like, what's he going to rhyme that with? Above you? I'm sure it's going to be an amazing rhyme. I'm just sort of obsessed with this choice. I have to ask him why this happens. Okay, by the way, don't know him at all, but I have to ask him. I guess on Twitter, at Tim Rice, UK, dot sir, dot lord. Okay, where was I? Okay, here we go. Rhyme scheme. Rhyme with violence? Mayim Bialik? Okay, I'm out. But anyway, it's all good. So then we go into the next, right? This is the dance break. So now I'm going to the dance break. And you know, let's say most songs in a Broadway show, let's say when they have a dance break, they'll reference basically the original melody. Or let's say, Leonard Bernstein in the Middle of America will go into totally no. He'll go into totally like new melody. Angela Weber, he has all these recurring themes. So the dance break for Buenos Aires, or the underscore, whatever, is songs from, melodies from other songs. So this is Thus All the Fairy Stories End. What else I want to say? Oh yeah, you can hear the melody for Thus All the Fairy Stories End. But then on top of that, I want you to hear just how bizarre the meter is. It goes from, I wrote it down, 6 to 5 to 6, back to 5 to 3 to 7. I find it so creative. And then on top of that, the weird counter melodies in the violin. Okay, let's see if we can count it and hear all the weird violin. Okay, here we go. What's happening? Okay.
Even by the standards of Buenos Aires society, the gathering at the polo ground, the rose and the demolas, the hampers from Harrods, the clothes, the diamonds, the crystal, the wines, the procession of nannies from England and France. The result of the match? Oh yes, the home team won. But as the British ambassador pointed out, that didn't tidy the gathering at the polo ground. The rose and the demolas, the hampers from Harrods, the clothes, the diamonds, the crystal, the wines, the procession of nannies from England and France. The result of the match? Oh yes, the home team won. But as the British ambassador pointed out, that did not reflect badly on British horsemanship. Three of the Argentine players were educated at Eton.
Two, three, four, five, six, seven. By the way, my professor, Conrad Cummings, that was his name, at Oberlin, always said we're supposed to say Sev, because seven took too much time, so you have to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1. But it was always just, I always found it just weird. It's like, why am I nicknaming seven? Okay, where was I? Okay. Then the next phrase that we're going to hear is A New Argentina, which, by the way, happens in the radio show, I'm only a radio star with just one weekly show, or you're not decorating a girl, but it happens here also, so here we go. There's the drums, I love this. Sass drums. You want to hear? Or maybe I'll have to.
You're not decorating a girl for a night on the town.
Is it Chris?
And I'm not a secretary for getting kicks with a crown.
Okay, then there's this weird clapping section that I really do not understand. I don't understand the claps. And I think when I played this, wait, I know there was clapping in the audience when we played on Broadway. But anyway, when we did the benefit with Patty. My point is, I don't understand this clapping. And never have I heard clapping so off since Great Day from the Funny Lady movie. She goes, it's gonna be a great day. And I think it's gonna go, great day, But instead it goes, great day. I'm gonna play it right now. This clapping is crazy. This is a great day, then we'll go into Buenos Aires. But listen to this, here we go.
There's gonna be a
great day. It's so not unison, get ready?
Great day.
Listen to this. Okay, so that's exactly what this sounds like to me. So with the crazy clapping, is that all I have to say about the next section? crazy clapping, syncopation. Oh, okay. I love that this whole counter melody we're about to hear is all, you know, syncopation means you're on the and. The whole melody is one and two and three and four and one and two. It goes one and two and three and four and one and two and three and four and one and two. So the whole thing is syncopated. I love that. It's interesting. There's a, it's not called a figured bass. Well, it's kind of like a figured bass, meaning it just keeps repeating. All these things happen on top of it, and it's this. And everything happens on top of that bass. But the problem is, I just feel so bad here. Okay, what's this? The violinist's face when he has to play four pages of bottom, 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 bottom. While the trumpet's going bum 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 violin. Dum 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 bum. It's not since the elimination in a chorus line. I got to play piano for a chorus line and there's this really slow walk back to the line where they all have to line up, and no joke, it's probably 4 minutes of. Over and over and over again. So anyway, so the violins have that da-dum, ba-dum, ba-da-da-da-dum. And the last thing I want to say is, remember I said about how, here, I'm going to bring this over here. How we sort of, how Angela Weber sort of has atonal stuff and yet it totally works. Listen to these chords. What the hell? Actually, I think it's a C natural, sorry. And yet, when you hear it, you're like, I totally buy it. It doesn't sound like a cacophony. You're like, I buy it. Okay, is that all I want to say? Yeah, okay, here we go. First of all, syncopation. Looking long and long. Crazy chords. Supposed to represent the hockey in Buenos Aires? I don't know. It's long, it's good, but... Great day. What's that? Okay, you're a champ, you're a champ. Okay, so, by the way, what I feel so bad is that the violins, da-dum, ba-dum, ba-da-da-da, it finally ends. You're like, thank God, our boring line of playing just four notes is over. Actually, now they have to play even fewer notes. Yes, they play 16ths, but it's still, instead of going, they got rid of the A-flat, now it's just this. So it's one finger less. Just ba-da-dum. Sorry, violin, stop wishing for something because it actually backfires. Okay, so they're like, thank God it's over. It actually gets worse. Then I was always obsessed with Patti LuPone's Amazing Spanish. So, Rio de la Plata, Florida, Corrientes, Nueva. I'm obsessed when she sings Spanish. Here we go, okay. Violin, thank God our part is more fun now. Literally, I've totally forgot. It's the third rhyme. So wait, it's impress, excess, success, staying, playing, paying. Wait a minute. That's amazing. Tim Rice literally makes us wait like 110 measures for the last rhyme. Bravo, Tim Rice. I mean, sorry, at real Tim Rice UK dot, what is it? Lord dot sir. I'm so impressed I didn't realize that. Okay, here comes Rio de la Plata. Here we go. Okay, this is what I'm the most obsessed with. This is, you know, when I first did deconstructions when I was a kid, I would just lift up the needle on the Victrola. Maybe I'd lift up the needle and move it back just for certain notes, and I was obsessed with the stay back. I was obsessed with that E. So let's just first hear the build up to it. It's so exciting. All I want to know. Okay, so two things I want to say. First of all, the lead into it is so great. The bum 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 stand back. I love the, is that what it is? Bum 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 stand back. Oh, okay, look at the notes. That's what it is. Bum, stand back. So I'm obsessed with the lead into it. And also I love the trumpet button. Here we go. Here, listen. This. All I want to know. Stand back. What am I? So I'm almost positive I saw this on YouTube, a video of Julie. You know, Julie Moynihan has crazy, amazing Batmont. And I'm positive on the YouTube when she played Evita, she added a Batmont. So it was literally this. This is her leg. You have to look for it. Because you want to know what's going to get in me. Okay, that's the last thing I want to say. It's just how the... I got to bring this over. How crazy the chords get. It literally becomes flat out, like that. It goes... Then the very ending, this is the top note and the bottom note. I mean, I'm skipping the rest of the chord, but it's literally this. I just think it's so amazing. Like, I'm so not that type of composer. I'd be like this. I would just keep playing the melody. Instead, it's literally this. I don't know how people have those kind of ears to create that kind of stuff. So I love that. Is that all I want to say? Yeah, stomach! Okay, here we go. Let's listen to it one more time because I'm obsessed.
All I want to know. Stand back where the fight is. Because you want to know what you're going to get in me. Just a little touch of, just a little touch of, just a little touch of, just a quality.
One more time, this chord. Sorry, I'm obsessed. And bass.
Just a little touch
of salt on it. I'm out.